I'm grateful that we can be curious and open to learning new things. Sometimes Unitarian Universalism is described as being like a large church with a lot of different stained glass windows. And even though each window is different, we know that the same light shines through them all. This is how we feel about other religions. They are beautiful, and we admire them for their uniqueness. Today, we're honoring the Hindu festival of Diwali. This is an annual celebration that has a lot of different meanings. In fact, it has a different meaning in each region of India. For some, it is the story of King Rama defeating the demon king Ravana. For others, it's about the Christians defeating the demon serpent, Narayana. For others, still, it is the story of Lord Vishnu defeating the demon king Bali. Do you notice that in each of these stories, there is a god who is defeating a demon? The common thread between them is the victory of good over evil. Diwali is also a national holiday in India, and there are people who aren't Hindu who celebrate the festival with their own meanings. It includes Jains who celebrate spiritual awakening, Sikhs who celebrate an important spiritual leader being released from captivity, and Buddhists who celebrate the end of a bloody war coming to peace. And even though those stories are all different from the original Hindu stories, they all have a very similar meaning. No matter what stories people tell about the celebration of Diwali, or their reasons for celebration, they can all agree that this is about celebrating light, freedom, happiness, and prosperity, whatever form that takes for people. Diwali is a five-day festival, and in the Hindu celebration, there's one day that is set aside for honoring Lakshmi. We had a puja, a prayer for earlier. She is the symbol of the happy things that people think about during Diwali. Last week, we talked about a different goddess, Durga, and how she is the symbol of power in the battle of good against evil. Lakshmi is a symbol, too. She is the symbol of light, freedom, happiness, and prosperity. And earlier, we lit lanterns. We learned that people do this every year to celebrate Diwali. The lights are said to guide Lakshmi to their house. And this means that they are inviting light, freedom, happiness, and prosperity into their homes. I've been thinking a lot about what it means to put out little lights to guide a goddess. I think it's really special that at Diwali, humans have a role to play in bringing blessings into their homes. I like this idea better than passively hoping that something good will happen. And I also like it better than working hard to keep bad things from happening. The idea of working hard to make good things happen is much more appealing to me. It means that we have to take responsibility for bringing good things to our lives. And I think that seems fair. Unitarian Universalism teaches that we have the power to do good things, and we have the power to do bad things. And it's up to us to choose. We are responsible for our own actions. We're even responsible for coming up with our own belief system. Sometimes it's hard to know what is good and what is bad. One of the tricky things about life. That's part of why we have churches, is so that we have other people who can help us figure this out. And sometimes we do know what's good and what's bad, and we make a bad choice anyway. This is another time we need a church to uphold us while we get it together. Because we believe that we have to work to make it right. We don't get to just say, I made a mistake, I'm never going to talk to you again. We have to say, I made a mistake, and I want to work it out with you. In this church, we believe that when a person did something wrong, they can always work to make it right. We are responsible for making choices, and we mess up a lot, but what makes us good is that we keep trying. We love each other the whole time. In this way, we are like During Diwali, people light diyas to guide goodness into their homes. We do the same thing for each other all the time. When we are kind to someone, we are light. When we help another person, we are light. When we work to bring goodness to our world, we are light. We guide each other home to our true selves, our highest selves. This Diwali season, may each of you be blessed with light, the light of intellect over ignorance, the light of love over hate, the light of community over isolation. May you be blessed with freedom, freedom from the bondage of small things, freedom that expands outward to bring along people at the margins. May you be blessed with happiness, the happiness of a child's laughter, happiness of true and loving community, the happiness of being held in the warmth of family and friends. And may you be blessed with prosperity. Prosperity of financial resources that bring you peace of mind, but also prosperity of time well spent, prosperity of spirit that comes from using resources to make justice.